I see this magnificent painting in our collection, the first thing I think about is how art can either be a mirror or a window. In the case of this painting, actually both. If you look at it and you ask yourself what's going on here, well, obviously there's a crucifixion going on. But where is it happening and who is it happening in front of? There are really three spaces in the painting. There's the historical space, that is Jesus and Joseph Arimathea and the soldiers and Mary and John and the other Mary, right, all the protagonists. Then in the background, there is a northern Renaissance city. It's not a city in Palestine in the first century, right? It's a northern Renaissance city. But there's a third space and maybe even a fourth space. The third space is actually the space of the medieval protagonist who is down here, right? Presumably the patron of the painting, the man for whom the painting was painted. And the final space is the space defined by the rainbow and by the gold. It's been often pointed out about the painting also that it's designed for a particular space. And it is a window into several universes, the historical, the contemporary, the spiritual, right? It's also a mirror, right? It's a mirror of Brother Aurelius's internal concerns, perhaps his personal transformation. But it's also literally a mirror because in the armor of one of the soldiers at the far right, you see the reflection of a particular window. And it's quite likely that this painting was designed for a small private chapel or prayer room where it sat opposite a particular window so that the light falling on the painting causes a reflection of the window in the real world. This is so great, right? A window in the real world, right, in the painting, and that just gives me the shivers, right? It's wonderful to be able to conceptualize where the painting actually sat in space.